Hello, in this video we'll be demonstrating Cognitech VideoActive's active interface. The active interface is a user interface used by many of our tools and filters, designed for speed, flexibility, and precision in mind when processing images and video. For this demonstration, we'll be using the active interface with the obscure and highlight filters, both of which are found in the filters menu under editing. And I'll begin with the obscure filter. This filter allows you to obscure an image or a portion of an image. In this case, I only want to obscure the man's face, so I can do that by making a selection over his face, like this. And in real time, the filter is applied only to that specific area. The important thing to understand about the active interface is that everything happens in real time, so as I change parameter settings here, we will see those settings take effect right here in my selection area in real time. If I don't want that to happen, I can click on this active button. And now I can adjust my parameter settings, and nothing will happen until I reactivate the filter. I could also click on original to see the before and after of this image before it was processed with this particular filter. Another important thing to understand about the active interface is that you can have a lot of control over your processing by choosing different parameter settings for each individual frame of video. For example, we're on frame 1, and I have a parameter setting with 10. Now, if I go to a different frame, such as frame 20, I can have a parameter setting of, say, 30. And I can do this for each individual frame, depending on the needs of my evidence, image, or video. Now, if I wanted to very quickly copy over parameter settings from one frame to another, I can click on Copy. Then go to a desired frame. I'm back at frame 1, and I can choose paste. And we'll see that this number changes as I do that. Copy paste works on one individual video frame, but if I want to copy and paste over several video frames, I can choose copy and duplicate. And now every single frame of video will have the same parameter settings. I could even select a range of frames, such as from frame 1 through 30, adjust my parameter settings, and then copy, duplicate, and now frames 1 through 30, the selection I made, will have one set of parameters, and the other frames will have another set. So that way you can very, very quickly adjust parameter settings for a big group of frames. Something you may have noticed is that as I was editing frames, they became blue on the movie controller. The blue color indicates that a specific frame has had their parameters altered. If they have not been altered, the frames appear gray, and that just signifies that the frame will be processed at the default setting for the particular filter that you're using. In this case, the obscure filter, if I hit reset here, we'll see the default setting, and that is a setting of 8. And when I did that, you can see that the frame is no longer blue. Another thing you may have noticed is that the selection box I created only exists on frame 1, but not on any other frame. And that's because when you're working with the active interface, you have control over the selection box on each individual frame as well. And if I wanted to, I can copy over selection boxes with these copy, paste, and duplicate buttons. But earlier, we were using parameter mode, which only copies over parameters. I can switch it over to selection box mode, which will copy over selection boxes only. Or I can switch this over to parameter slash selection box mode, which will copy over my parameters and selection box. So let me show you that now. If I change my parameters, change my selection box, and then copy, duplicate, we can see that now every single frame will have that box in that same location and will have the same parameters. Now let me show you some advanced things that we can do with these selection boxes and the active interface with the highlight filter. So let me close this, and I will not save it. I'll go to Editing, Highlight. As you may have imagined, the highlight filter allows you to highlight an image or a portion of an image. In this case, again, I want to highlight only the man's face. and I want to copy over my selection box to every single frame, and I want to copy my current parameters to every single frame because they do not exist on other frames. So I'll switch over to selection box and parameter mode, copy, duplicate, and now we have the same settings and the same selection box on every single frame. But if I play this video, we can see that the man's face does not stay in the same location, so we'll have to have a different selection box over every frame in order to track the man. We can do this in a couple different ways. I could manually move the selection box from frame to frame like this in order to track this individual. I could also grab a range of frames like this by holding shift and dragging the cursor over the movie controller, and then copy, duplicate my selection box, and then do that again. And that way, I can ensure that the man's face will stay under a selection box over a group of frames and very quickly track him. And lastly, there is an even faster method, which I enjoy, which is by pressing play and dragging the selection box to the mouse, we can very quickly track an object in motion. Now, I didn't let go fast enough, so I will have to adjust some frames manually. Let's see. But just like that, very quickly, I was able to track this person. It looks like maybe there was one more. Frame 3. Okay, and now that we've done that, we can click on Process, Finish, and if I play back the video, we'll have a highlight filter applied over a tracked area. So that's it for the active interface for this video. We hope you found that helpful. Thank you for watching.